we know the result of first law of thermodynamics. If the two systems are in thermal equilibrium with the third system, then the two systems are also in thermal equilibrium. When the two systems are in thermal equilibrium, there is no transfer of heat. Temperature difference is responsible for the flow of heat. If the two systems are at same temperature, then there is no heat flow between them. So this flow of heat energy is due to the temperature difference. So that property is used to give the meaning definition of heat. So heat can be explained like this. Heat is a form of energy that is transferred between a system and its surrounding or environment. Heat is a form of energy that is transferred between a system and its environment. When temperature difference exists between them, no temperature difference, no flow of heat. So this is the meaning of heat. Heat flow is caused by temperature difference. Now let us see this second term. What is meant by internal energy? It is denoted by U. Internal energy is denoted by U. So what is the meaning of internal energy, that we have to see. Now we know some example of thermodynamical phenomena. When we drive a vehicle, the engine gets heated. Engine do some work and therefore heat is produced. So engine gets heated by rubbing the palms, heat is generated. So like this, there are so many phenomena in which the heat is the producer. So all these phenomena are explained on the basis of the concept of internal energy of the system, which is denoted by U. So this internal energy of the system, the conversion of work and heat into the other form, into each other, and laws governing them, like this. So what to explain these phenomena? They are also called as a thermodynamical phenomena. So for explanation, these terms are necessary: internal energy, heat energy, work done, etc. And therefore, the meaning of this article is like this. So again, we will see the examples like this. Engine produces heat when vehicle is running. Vehicle is running.
rubbing of plum, rubbing the plums, produces heat. Such phenomena. What to explain these phenomena? Such phenomena are explained by using this concept of internal energy. Such phenomena are explained on the basis of first concept of internal energy. Second, interconversion. The conversion of work and heat. And the third part is the laws governing this phenomena. Zeroth law, first law, second law, etc. governing these interconversion. Interconversion दोगे प्रकार के हैं ना. Interconversion. For example, we know this well known equation. W is equal to JH. W is a work done. H is a heat energy producer. It is a coupon symbol on its Q or H. And J is a mechanical equivalent of heat. Mechanical equivalent of heat. Yeah, J is a valuable of the lava 4.2 joule per calorie. It is a hybrid unit. It is equal to 4200 joule per kilocalorie. Like this, sir. So this is one law. Work and heat energy, they are interconvertible, like this, sir. So this is the meaning. What is the importance of the internal energy? This measurement of internal energy is used to explain this the phenomena. Concept of internal energy is used conversion of work and heat and law governing the conversion and so on. So this is one example. This is also called as the Joule's law of heating. Joule's law of heating. Joule's law of heating. In this case, W is a work done. That work done may be mechanical work or it may be the electrical work. So when we pass the current through a conductor, then heat is produced because work is done, electrical work is done by that. Now, what is the meaning of internal energy? How it is defined? That now we have to see. Set that. So we are going to see this second part now in detail. Internal energy. Internal energy is defined like this. Definition of internal energy. Definition of internal energy. Internal energy of a system. So it is defined as the energy associated with the random and disordered motion of the molecules of a system. So definition is given like this. It is internal energy is defined as the energy associated with random and disordered motion of atoms and molecules of the system. Random and disordered motion. So this type of motion is generally observed for gas molecule and the liquid molecule. In case of solid molecule, this is not possible because the molecule inside the solid, they have no translational motion. They have only vibrational motion. So when we consider this type, this internal energy of the gaseous system or liquid system are preferred like this. So for solid we consider the energy, but that is the macroscopic and ordered energy of the moving object. So this random and disordered motion is a observed for gas and liquid molecules. And then what we have to consider the internal energy of the gaseous and liquid molecules. So this is the first one, definition. Second point, it means this internal energy of, in general, glass and liquid, they are called as a fluid. Internal energy of the fluids is a different from the ordered solid मध्ये आपल्याला ऑर्डर मोशन मिळते. मॅक्रोस्कोपिक ऑर्डर एनर्जी इट इज डिफरंट फ्रॉम मॅक्रोस्कोपिक ऑर्डर्ड एनर्जी ऑफ मूव्हिंग ऑब्जेक्ट. These objects are generally solids. Now, what is the difference between these two? So, we can give two examples. Third case. Now, suppose this is a cylinder filled with a gas. For domestic purposes, for cooking, we are using the cylinder. So, cylinder as a whole is a macroscopic body and it is at rest. So, it has no motion, no kinetic energy, no potential energy. It is on the surface of the earth, it has no potential energy. But what is about the gas molecule? The gas molecule inside the cylinder, they are moving continuously. Their motion stops only at absolute zero temperature. Therefore, even at room temperature, the gas molecules are always in motion and they will have certain energy. And we already know that energy, the kinetic energy per molecule is equal to 3 by 2 kT.
where K is a Boltzmann constant. So this energy corresponds to the internal energy. Random and disordered motion is observed in gas and liquid molecule, and this energy is like this. Apan mage 1 mole 31 energy ghadleli, kinetic energy per mole. This is per molecule. Kinetic energy per mole is equal to 3 by 2 RT upon 1, where R is a universal gas constant. This K is a Boltzmann constant, like this. So this energy contributes for the internal energy of the system. Upon degree of freedom, the article will be used. So that is what they have FRT by 2, where F is the degree of freedom, R is the this value, like this. So FRT by 2 is the general value, kinetic energy for 1 mole of gas, where F is the degree of freedom. The degree of freedom ke value, monoatomic, diatomic, and triatomic gas study, we calculate till here. So what is the meaning is this? This cylinder is a macroscopic body. When it is in motion, it will have energy that is calculated by 1 half m square. M is the mass of the cylinder, v is the velocity. But when the body is at rest, this cylinder has no energy, no kinetic energy, no potential energy. But the gas inside it, it is microscopic system. It will have certain energy, and that energy can be calculated like this. So the meaning of internal energy is this. It is related with the gaseous system and liquid system. So it is related with fluids. The meaning is this. Solid study internal energy is a bigger question. So the third example given in our notes is this. Consider consider a glass of water at rest on ground. At rest, therefore, its kinetic energy is equal to 0. It is on ground, therefore, its potential energy is also 0, and therefore, it has the glass has no energy. Its total energy is 0. But due to the random motion, but at room temperature, the water molecule have random motion and has some internal energy. Thus, internal energy of the substance is the total energy of the all atoms and molecules. Dar a glass beaker motion madhe asel tar tyachi pan energy aapala add karta yeil. So next point, how we can calculate this internal energy of the system. So internal energy of the substance is equal to, the substance may be in solid or liquid state, internal energy of a substance is equal to sum of all energies of the atoms and molecules. Atoms and molecules is a glass container. It is denoted by One more example, not given in our notes. For a gas molecule, single molecule, kinetic energy is equal to 3/2 kT, where K is a Boltzmann constant. T is a temperature in Kelvin, like this. Kinetic energy of 1 mole of gas K is equal to 3/2 RT. So these two energies contribute for the internal energy of the gas. Even though the container filled with the gas, the container may be at rest. So container had zero kinetic energy, zero potential energy, but the molecules of the gas inside the container has random motion, disordered motion, and in this motion they have energy, and that energy can be calculated by this type of equation. The equation already upon derived the kinetic theory of gas, as a assumption magari use. So this is the meaning of internal energy. Now this internal energy can be changed either by doing the work or by heating. Both processes we have to see separately. So now when we consider the interrelationship between this work done and heat, etc., we are always considering some phenomena which involve the thermodynamical system. So what is meant by thermodynamical system? For example, when we take a water in a beaker and boil it, it is system. So that beaker is the boundary which bound the liquid water, and the surrounding atmosphere, it is called as a environment, and that water is a system, like this. So this type of system can be used, can be studied by using the laws of thermodynamics. So meaning of the thermodynamic system is very simple. You can say the definition. It is a collection or group of objects that can form a unit. So definition can be given like this. It is a collection or group of objects particles which forms a unit. It is called as a system. Ek assembly hai jo. So water in a beaker. So water, beaker, these are the objects, and they form a system. It is a collection of or group of object or particle which form a unit that has ability to exchange or to transfer the energy with the surrounding. Heat energy the surrounding, again mechanical energy pronounced. So we will use the general word that has the ability to exchange the energy with the environment. Environment. This is the meaning of thermodynamical system. Now let us see the second term, B. What is meant by environment? It is also called as the surrounding. The second term in relation with the thermodynamic system is the B. Environment
surrounding
or surrounding anything anything that is not a part of system is called surrounding or environment or you can also give the meaning is like this everything which is outside the system is called surrounding is called surrounding and the last term is boundary The surface separating the system and the surrounding is called as boundary. The surface separating, it is a surface of separation. A surface separating the system and its surrounding. The surface separating the system and the surrounding is called boundary. It's called as boundary. So suppose we consider this arrangement. This is the beaker. This is water. Like this. So. Water is kept in a vessel is a system. Consider water kept in a beaker. So this beaker is a boundary. This is a system and this is a surrounding. The surrounding atmosphere is called as a surrounding. The vessel, atmosphere around the vessel is the surrounding. So now let us see the different types of thermodynamic systems. The first one is the open system. The name itself suggests that there is a exchange of matter as well as energy between the system and the surrounding. So by figure we can show this arrangement like this. So this is a system, this is a surrounding. So there is a exchange of energy as well as there is a exchange of matter. Exchange of energy and matter. Both exchange of energy and matter takes place between system and
its environment. Water boiling in open beaker.
So when we heat the water in a beaker, then during the process of boiling, some vapor, water vapor, is escape into the surrounding air, and also the energy is given to the surrounding. So both energy as well as the matter, water, water molecule get escape. So there is an exchange of water. After heating for long time, the mass of the water in a beaker will decrease. Why? Because some matter in the form of water vapor are going out of the system. So this is a simple example. ये जो उलट अपना एक दंपल का देते हैं, सेकंड एग्जांपल,
क्लोज्ड सिस्टम,
क्लोज्ड सिस्टम. इन दिस केस देयर इज नो एक्सचेंज ऑफ मैटर, ओनली एनर्जी कैन एक्सचेंज.
सिस्टम सराउंडिंग heat energy can go up to. So there is exchange of heat energy, but no exchange of matter. Example, boiler.
So there is no exchange of matter, the content remains the same, only heat is exchanged. Or you can also give one example, a gas enclosed in a cylinder. In a cylinder with airtight piston. So there is no leakage. Airtight piston and heated by supplying heat. Heated by supplying heat energy. So you can show this example. This is the piston. This is the gas enclosed, and the heat energy is supplied. Heat may be supplied at constant pressure or at constant volume. Mayer's relation derived from the Sanapani Ashe system used clearly. When we have to keep the volume constant, means this, the heated by supplying the heat energy at constant volume. So volume is kept constant, means there is no this change in the position of the piston, and there is no exchange of matter like this. The third system is the isolated system. Isolated system. No exchange of matter and energy. System surrounding. There is no exchange of heat energy as well as the matter. एग्जाम्पल बुक्स मध्ये सर्व हेच एग्जाम्पल लिहिलेले आहे. बॉइलिंग वॉटर इन मे थर्मल फ्लास्क, Thermos flask is the best example of isolated system like this. So open system, closed system and isolated system. Isolated system exists theoretically, practically it is not possible like this. So these are the terms related with the thermodynamical system and their classification, their types. Now let us consider the flow of energy into or out of the thermodynamical system. So for that purpose we are going to consider this type of situation. Consider a system kept in an environment. Let TS is equal to temperature of the system. TE is equal to temperature of environment and Q is equal to energy flowing between system and surface. System and environment. Energy flowing or energy transfer. Transfer is the correct word. Energy transferred between the system and the environment. So in this case, we have to consider the three cases. Case number one. When temperature of the surrounding is less than the temperature of the environment. So environment is at higher temperature and therefore the energy flows from higher temperature to lower temperature. So in this case the arrangement is like this. Suppose this is a system at temperature TS. This is the environment at temperature TE. So TE is greater than, therefore heat will flow. Flow of heat energy into the system. So in this case Q is greater than 1. Since environment is at higher temperature, is at higher temperature than system, therefore energy flow, energy to flow into the system energy flow into the system and as a result therefore system gains energy and therefore Q is greater than 0, that is Q is positive. Actually हे thermodynamics मधले sign convention तशी आपण sign rule use करतो. Any vector in positive x direction is taken as positive, तसं तिथे पण आहे. If the energy increases then plus sign, if energy decreases then minus sign. So these are the convention. Therefore in this case Q is positive like this. Now second case. Thank you. केस नंबर टू. आता अपन रिवर्स सिचुएशन घेतो. व्हेन द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द सिस्टम इज ग्रेटर दॅन टेम्परेचर ऑफ द एन्व्हायरमेंट.
तर याचं एक्झाम्पल काय देतं आपल्याला? आईस केप्ट इन लुकवॉर्म वॉटर ऑर ऑन ए टेबल. एक्झाम्पल
an ice cube kept on a table. So environment is surrounding, it is at 27 degree Celsius and ice is at 0 degree Celsius, like this. So in this case TS is equal to 0 degree Celsius and TE is equal to room temperature. Second case, hot body kept in cold surrounding. Example, water boiling in open beaker. Open beaker. So in this case, this water is a system. So TS is equal to 100 degree Celsius, and this T environment is equal to 27 degree Celsius, room temperature. So this is a system. TS, this is the environment. T. So in this case, heat will go out. So in this case, Q is decreasing. So Q is less than zero. Q is negative, like this. So heat energy flows from system into the environment. So heat energy Q is going out. In this case, since the environment is at lower temperature, energy Q, since environment is at lower temperature than system, therefore energy Q flow into environment, and therefore this system loses energy. Therefore Q is less than zero, Q is negative. Gain in energy plus sign, loss in energy minus sign. And the third case, the third case is not given in our notes, so please check this. Case number three. Add. What is this third case? Well, TS is equal to TE. So by figure you can give like this. System environment boundary. System at temperature TS, environment at temperature T. Since TS is equal to T, therefore system and environment, system and its environment are in thermal equilibrium, same temperature, thermal equilibrium, thermal equilibrium. Therefore, we know the definition of thermal equilibrium: no flow of energy. Therefore, Q is equal to zero. Q is equal to zero. Q is greater than zero, positive. Q is less than zero, negative. And Q is equal to zero. There is no flow of energy like this. So these are the three cases. So depending upon the temperature of surrounding and environment. So we already know this principle: the temperature difference produces the flow of energy from higher temperature to lower temperature. And therefore, in case number one, here, in case number one, environment is at higher temperature, therefore energy will flow from environment into the system, and therefore system gains energy, it will positive, and Q is taken as positive, Q is taken as negative, Q is equal to zero. So gain in energy, Q is positive, loss in energy, Q is negative. These are the sign convention used like this. Here we have considered the general example of any thermodynamical system. So when environment is at higher temperature, the energy flows into the system and internal energy increases, decreases, remains constant like this. So particularly for gaseous system, means closed system, gas enclosed by a piston, airtight piston. So this change in internal energy can be brought by two methods. One is by heating and other is by doing the work. So both method to change the internal energy of the gaseous system, both methods are used, and we have to see them separately, what are their characteristics, etc. So next time we will see the change in the internal energy of the gas. Okay, we will stop here.